Rank, rank, rank. What does rank mean? This is a fascinating topic to me, and partially because this does not just apply to Tekken rank. Of course, that's what I'm talking about because I'm teaching Tekken, but I would imagine this applies to a lot of games that have a competitive rank mode. And one of the most popular phrases I hear is rank doesn't mean anything. I would imagine you guys actually hear that too. I have a hard time believing I'm the only person who hears that phrase a lot. And I remember the first time I heard that, I had a flashback to when I first started training in MMA and started competing, because I grew up with people saying size doesn't matter in a fight, right? And I remember I told my coach that. I was like, man, I don't even see the point of weight divisions. Size doesn't matter. And my coach looked at me like, who told you that nonsense? Size absolutely matters in a fight. And I believe the middleweight champ at the time, Evan Tanner, had basically gave this speech before one of his fights, and he was like, yeah, all things being equal, the man with the bigger man has an advantage, basically saying size does matter. It is an attribute. Not saying this directly translates to what I'm about to say about rank, but I'm just saying it. I wonder how many other things out there that are big controversial topics that people saying don't mean anything and actually does mean something. But anyway, yeah, that's a popular phrase. Rank doesn't mean anything. And I hear this from a lot of people. I hear this from people in the green ranks that have like 1,000 wins. And I hear this people from like Mighty Ruler ranks or Fusion ranks that have thousands of wins. And I've heard this from competitive and pro players, which we all look up to because they're, you know, 10 times better than us. And they say the same thing. Rank doesn't mean anything, right? Now, I've heard a few, I believe, competitive players say it does mean something, and maybe a couple pro players. I can't think of off the top of my head, so maybe it's just competitive players or content creators that say it. But point is, what do you guys think about this? Do you guys agree? Do you guys feel that rank doesn't mean anything, or do you feel it has some form of value to it? And before I give you my thoughts on this and before we discuss it, I do want to stop first and say, let's talk about what is the point of having a rank mode in a competitive game. And I want to keep it simple. So keeping it simple, rank is supposed to tell you how good you are, or maybe a better way of saying it is how skillful you are relative to other people that play rank. And it does this typically by grouping you with a pool of players that's supposed to be around your same skill level. And if you find yourself winning a high enough percentage of your matches, then you move up in rank. And for Tekken, we typically get titles for that rank, you know, Genbu, Vanquisher, Mighty Ruler, Fusion. Other games, you might have a point system where you have way more points than somebody else. Or like in Dead by Daylight, you went from rank 20 to rank 1. So typically you would assume somebody that's rank 1 that's playing the game actively, and somebody who's rank 20 that's playing the game actively in Dead by Daylight, the rank 1 player is a better player. That's what you would assume, right? Now let me get into a little bit more depth with Tekken here. How accurate is this system? How accurate is Tekken rank system? In my opinion, and that is just my opinion, it's about 50% accurate, give or take 10%. So you can say 40%, 60%, I wouldn't argue. My point is, it's not 100% accurate. And if we're being technical, 50% out of 100, you're still failing the test. 9 times out of 10, and I have to say 9 times out of 10 because, you know, some tests are so hard that 50% is a C because of the curve. But I digress. Let me give you a use case of why I say this. I've seen situations where a Vanguard Jhin, you know, I'm playing with a group of friends or people I don't know, you know, people start talking and people start getting pissed off, and hey, shut up, you suck, man, whatever, you just using lay, okay, first to 10, first to 5, whatever, and then they start playing, right? And the case where you have a Vanguard like Jhin player versus a Destroyer Lei, and the Jhin player, say first to 10 or first to 5, like I was saying, and the Jhin player walks through the Lei player, beats him 10 to 4. And this is a case where we've played enough where there's no trickery here in the sense that they both know the matchup. That's very, very important because Tekken is a knowledge-based game in so many areas where if the person doesn't have the proper knowledge to deal with something, fundamentals sometimes are not good enough, sadly, and that's just the way it is. You gotta get over that. That's just the way it is. And Lei is a trickster. He is a party character in this game, and I love Lei. This is no shade to Lei players. Lei, honestly, is one of my main 5 characters that I play. I love Lei. But that being said, he's wild. He has a lot of moves. I think Lei has something like 200-300 moves, so it's very easy to play a Lei player and not have a clue what's going on, whereas Jhin is a very popular player, way more popular than Lei, so in a lot of cases you have an idea of how to fight him. But in this case, my point is the Vanguard Gen ran through the Destroyer leg. If we were going off the accuracy of rank saying, hey, he's Vanguard, and then this guy's Destroyer, the Destroyer should have destroyed him, right? You like how I said that? Destroyer, destroy him? But that didn't happen. Okay, so obviously it's not 100% accurate. In my use case scenario, they are about roughly like 6 ranks apart, and at least at the time, in my opinion, the lower ranking player was just more fundamentally sound and probably an overall better skill based player. So you probably could have made that a first to 20, and it could have been 8 or 9 ranks apart, and I don't think it would have changed very much. But playing devil's advocate just a little bit and flipping it, bottom line was I was very clear when I was saying that they both were very aware of the other character's strengths and weaknesses. So it wasn't so much like a big knowledge check, because this could go both ways. You could have a higher ranking Gen player lose to a lower ranking late player because, again, he doesn't know the matchup. I was just trying to illustrate a point with the ranks for lower versus higher, but that can be flipped. It could be higher versus lower. It could be the exact same results where the Gen player is losing to a lower rank late player because he doesn't know the matchup, and that wouldn't directly translate so much into skill. Or it could be a case where I remember playing in a session with just me and a friend of mine. I think at the time I was either Raijin or Emperor, and my friend was Tekken God Prime, and I beat him like 2 or 3 times. And the people in the player session that we did know was kind of, I don't want to say it was talking crap, but at the end of the day, it was coming back like, hey, you know, you shouldn't be losing. And it had nothing to do with who is the better player so much as it had to do with the fact that me and my friend played each other a lot, so we knew the matchup. So in that particular case, I don't think rank meant anything because we played each other so much, we knew the matchup for him and for me. So point is here, when I hear people say rank doesn't mean anything, what I personally feel like they're saying is rank doesn't mean you are going to win. I'm gonna say that again. When I hear people say rank doesn't mean anything, I feel like what they're really trying to say, or what they're saying, is rank doesn't mean you are going to win. Rank doesn't mean you are the more skillful player. Okay? And I actually agree with that. I 100% agree with that. Now, going into my own experiences, thoughts on this, does rank mean anything? Hell yes, it does. In my opinion, hell yes, rank does mean something if you earned your rank honestly. And let me explain what I mean when I say this. Honestly, there are so many ways to cheat in Tekken. I'm not going to get into the depth of that because I made a video of Tekken PC versus Tekken PS4 or whatever, and I went into details there. But there are so many ways to cheat, and it allows you to rank up much easier. There are so many ways to get around. Like, I have friends who, well, I shouldn't say friends, but I have people I play with from time to time, and they do things I completely don't agree with. So, for example, one person I know, he plugs if he comes across a DLC character that he didn't purchase. And it bothers me because I don't think he should plug, but he plugs at the beginning of the screen, or so he tells me. He plugs when he sees the player. I mean, he sees the character he's going to play, and he's like, okay, I can't lab this character. I'm at a disadvantage. Why do I have to deal with that? They should at least make it where I can lab the character. And I can kind of understand that because it does seem like he's at a disadvantage. Personally, I think he shouldn't plug. He should learn as much as he can by playing people. Maybe he'll find somebody he can run a death match with. But he shouldn't also be forced to buy the character either. So that's, I kind of understand his point a little bit. But then I know people who plug when they come across a king, or they plug when they see Haorang. You know, they're like, hey, Haorang's busted. King's throws are busted. I'm like, dude, you can learn the matchup. You don't have to plug it. This is a base character. You can learn the matchup. And what's worse is Haorang and King are probably going to be in Tekken 8. So you're going to plug for the rest of the Tekken? What? Every time you play Tekken 8, Tekken 9, you're going to keep plugging? That's dumb to me. Learn the matchup. Don't be lazy. But anyway, that's examples of what I mean when I say dishonest. As far as honestly, basically I'm just saying play honest, no lag switching. Win or lose, you know, that's what you get, okay? You know, and I honestly think people who do that will notice as they rank up, they're getting better and better and better. And I think there's value to that. I think you should be very proud of yourself because Tekken to me is not an easy game. Yes, I know, I've heard people say Tag 2 is much harder. Probably true. I didn't play Tag 2. I didn't play 6. I didn't play 5. But I don't think that devalues the fact that Tekken 7 is still a hard game for new people to pick up, at least in my opinion. Also, in my experience, when I was brawler, when I was in the green ranks, people weren't sidestepping. When I moved up in rank, I noticed people started to sidestep more. When I moved up in rank again, I noticed people started to sidestep and duck. When I moved up in rank again, I noticed people started to sidestep and duck and punish properly more. As I play people in higher rank, they start to do things that I feel like they don't do in the lower ranks. So I feel like that's directly a relation of what they learned over the years from playing rank or whatever. You know, my point is people are a little bit more knowledgeable or just more knowledgeable in general when you get to a higher rank on average. Even flowcharts, you know, a lay player or Yoshi player probably don't have the same knowledge of in-depth stances and flowcharts and setups like that that they do when they get higher ranks on average. So yes, this is just my opinion. I do think on average, if you are playing honestly, then yeah, I do think there is some value to rank. I do think there's a big difference of me playing somebody who is a Fusion Brian versus somebody who is a Brawler Brian. But that is just my opinion. Please post your comments below and thoughts on this. If you guys like the content, as I always say, I always appreciate you guys' feedback. I appreciate all you guys' support. It really means a lot to me. Please consider liking and subscribing. This is Acid Light. You guys take care.